Hello and welcome to our special program, To The Point. Elections in Delhi are an important affair. Everybody seems to have their eyes set on the processes which are taking place in different political parties, as well as the entire electoral process which has already begun. We have with us today Congress's senior leader and face, the party's face in these elections, Mr. Ajay Maken. He's also the general secretary as well as the chief of the Congress's campaign committee in the state of Delhi. So welcome to Rajya Sabha Television. Ajay Maken as the face of the Congress, couldn't it have been done a bit earlier?
Well, how could it have been done earlier? I contested my own Lok Sabha election just 7 months back. Our main opposition party, the BJP, I think this fight would be between Congress and BJP. Our main opposition party has inducted Kiran Bedi as its face. And before that, I was appointed as the campaign committee chief. So I don't think that it is too late. And with the advent of electronic and social media in a compact place like Delhi, compact city like city state like Delhi, I don't think that communicating to our electorate would be a problem. Had it been some far-flung rural areas, of course, it would have been late. But a compact city state like Delhi, I don't think it is late.
I would have asked this question a little later in the interview, but since you mentioned and quite significant statement you made, that is the main opponent you're considering is BJP. What about the third and most important player out here, Aam Aadmi Party, which formed the government in the previous assembly, supported by your party only? They were their leader was the chief minister.
Well, my strong belief in this stems from the fact that in Delhi Cantonment Board elections, where 60,000 people, they are the electorate, and more than 35,000-40,000 people went and polled for the elections. They were the same people who voted in last parliament and in assembly elections. There, the Congress got 11% more as compared to last assembly elections, mm-hmm. and much more than as compared to last parliament elections. Mm-hmm. The Aam Aadmi Party dipped by 15%. And BJP dipped by 3%. We got double the number of seats than the Aam Aadmi Party. So, and there the sitting MLA is that of the Aam Aadmi Party. So, the same place where 1 year back, Aam Aadmi Party had a sitting MLA, there in the same assembly seat, out of 60,000-70,000 electorate, the cantonment board elections, we got 11% more votes, double the number of seats than Aam Aadmi Party, and it was a very close contest between the Congress and the BJP.
But isn't this comparison a little mismatched, because as far as cantonment board elections are concerned, they're more concentrated more or less in one assembly segment. It can be a reflection of one assembly segment, maybe nearby a few more assembly segments, but this is 70 seats.
Any person having bit of knowledge of Delhi politics, the way it goes, would also support my point of view, because in Delhi, the parliament elections, if you look at, always it is 7-0, 6-1. The assembly elections, if you look at, it is 50-20. So it is always one-sided affair. Like in 93, we were totally washed out with just 14 out of 70 seats. Then in 98, BJP was totally washed out with just 15 out of 70 seats. So it is one way or the other. And the kind of thinking or feeling which is there in one part of Delhi, Delhi being so compact, people crisscrossing every place in Delhi so many times a week, so many times a day rather, they think alike, and Delhi doesn't Delhi geographically is a very small area, so it doesn't happen in Delhi politically that people in one corner think differently and the other corner think differently.
I get your point, but some would say that your argument might have held water till 2013 elections. That is the idea of electorate going either this way or that way, either choosing Congress or BJP. But in 2013 we saw a new player entering the scenario, that's Aam Aadmi Party, and we had a fractured mandate. Do you subscribe to this fact that things have definitely changed as far as political scene in Delhi is concerned after the entry of Aam Aadmi Party?
Definitely, yes. If I do not admit, perhaps I'll be fooling myself or your viewers. Aam Aadmi Party became a major player ever since they formed a party and became a part of political spectrum in Delhi. But you should also not forget that they got a chance in 49 days. So why we are confident is that earlier in 2013, when we went in for poll, for 15 years we were in power. And BJP and Aam Aadmi Party both were hitting out at us like anything. Both were promising everything and anything on earth to the electorate. So what good has happened for us is that last 1 year, both the BJP, through President's rule, through Narendra Modi's direct rule in last 7 months, and before that, Arvind Kejriwal's 49 days governance, people have already seen. And the kind of tall promises with both, which both of them made, they have been unable to fulfill. Like the electricity reduction of tariff in electricity, Arvind Kejriwal couldn't rein in these private distribution companies who are taking because of the excess tariff which they are charging, they are burden is on the consumer. He couldn't rein in these private companies. The promises which he made, like he said, I will hold Janta Darbar every day. He held it for one day, then ran away. Then he said that austerity measure, I will live like a common man. This is in a signed affidavit, he said. And ultimately, he got 8-room house for himself. And this is what his office said. All their ministers, they came for the oath-taking ceremony, grand gala oath-taking ceremony at Red Fort grounds, at Ramlila grounds. In a metro, in a three-wheeler, and then they started asking for SUVs for themselves so that they can use SUVs as a minister. So all these tamashas, these things, people of Delhi have already seen. On Rajpath, imagine the chief minister sitting just before the 26-day parade and making dharna against the central government. So this is not what is expected out of the chief minister. When you are the chief minister, you are the ruling party, you are the chief minister, you have to deliver. You shouldn't be seen just taking dharnas and aggressively going on street against the central government. You have to perform, not shift blame on the others. So this is exactly what Arvind Kejriwal has done, and perhaps this is what is reflective of the moods of people in Delhi cantonment board elections also.
Okay, you made an elaborate answer about wherein Aam Aadmi Party has been lacking and what can be the charges against them. Let's take it issue by issue. Let's start with the issue of power supply. Now, on the issue of power supply, Aam Aadmi Party is repeating its promises. It's saying that, see, when we were in the power, we halved the electricity bills. We will do it again when we come. Let me complete it. And from BJP's side, the Prime Minister in their inaugural rally for the Delhi Assembly elections also made a promise on the power sector to the people, saying that there will be an option for the people to go from one subscriber to the other, which will bring down the prices. What is your party's agenda as far as power sector is concerned for the people of Delhi?
Let me tell you, the problem of power sector in Delhi is not power supply. It is the tariff. Delhi gets much better supply of power as compared to 98 when we came to power for the first time in Delhi. Delhi is power scenario is much better than perhaps any other part of the country except for Mumbai. The problem in Delhi is that in 2003, when we privatized the power sector, at that time the AT&C, the theft losses were 54%. Mm-hmm. It has come down to 13%. Mm-hmm. So this 41% reduction in power theft in Delhi, that benefit should have gone to the end user, to the consumer.
But you were in power till 2013. Why didn't it go?
Let me finish. Unfortunately, the regulatory commission, which is supposed to act as a watchdog, they allowed these private companies to build capex, the capital expansion, in such a way that they showed on in their books that they are spending a huge amount of money in capital expansion, which perhaps was not required or which perhaps was not spent even. Mm-hmm. So what the only way to reduce the power tariff in Delhi is to rein in these power companies. Huge regulatory assets have been formed. 20,000 crore rupees of worth of regulatory assets have been formed, and the consumer is to pay for that. So the regulatory commission has to perform as an effective watchdog. So the problem lies with the regulatory commission, which should rein in these private companies, and the government at the time of selection of the members of regulatory commission, and also should, through certain legislation, ensure that the regulatory commission performs well. So if you want to improve the power supply in Delhi, it is not just by making tall false promises. Arvind Kejriwal didn't reduce the power tariff to half. To a limited usage, to first few hundred units, only the power tariff went down. But again, that was through the subsidy, through the taxpayers' money. That money could have been better utilized to construct houses for the poor shelterless people or for the poor slum dwellers. That money could have been better utilized for fixing leakages of pipeline for water supply. That money could have been better utilized to construct more flyovers to bring in more metro. So instead of spending money in the development work, he handed over that money to the private companies so that he can go back to the people again and say that this is not the right way. Just by giving subsidy to the private companies. It is not giving subsidy to the people. Giving subsidy to the private companies, handing over money to the private companies is the most, I think, the worst way, and it is going to make these private companies more inefficient and more corrupt.
So what would be the Congress's solution to this problem if voted to power under the leadership of Ajay Maken?
The Congress's solution, as I said, the solution lies in effective working of the regulatory commission. DERC, the Delhi Electric Regulatory Commission's members' appointments need to be streamlined. And there are post-retirement also, it should be ensured that no such member post-retirement should be given plum jobs in any of these companies or any companies related to these companies, which has been happening in the past. So at the time of appointment to the Electricity Regulatory Commission, due care should be taken, which was perhaps not taken earlier.
Okay, we will continue this conversation with Congress leader Ajay Maken, but let's take a short break here. Welcome back. Congress leader Ajay Maken is still with us. Sir, we have had a word about power, the issue of power. Let's talk about one very important issue, which seems to have been swept under the carpet by the both national parties. That is the issue of statehood for Delhi. This is something which was a poll issue for BJP for quite some time. This was also raised by your party for quite some time, but seems to have been on the back burner this time around. What is Congress's stand on granting full statehood to Delhi?
Well, the exact position of the Congress or the promise you will come to know when we release our manifesto. But let me tell you one thing. As I am the only person in Delhi ever to be the cabinet minister in the state government and to be a cabinet minister in the center government, both. So I have seen both the sides. So people in Delhi, they ask for statehood. But the problem is that Delhi is a national capital. Being national capital, we have parliament here. We have our Republic Day parade here. So imagine police being under Delhi government and as Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal on 25th January holding a dharna at Rajpath. And this is something what I am saying is something which happened, almost happened last time. Police being under him, so who would remove the Chief Minister of Delhi from Rajpath? Do you think at that time the military, which is supposed to take part in parade, will come with their tanks and remove the Chief Minister of Delhi? Imagine,
so
Obama.
You believe there will be a conflict of interest?
Imagine Obama coming to Delhi, police, traffic police, being with Delhi government. And Delhi government is that of a party who doesn't believe that Obama is good for India. So Delhi government's political party says that we should boycott Obama. We should not let Obama come to Delhi. So they will stop Obama from entering into Delhi right at the airport with the police they have. So do you think at that time the government of India should use military, government of India should use military Indian armed forces against the Delhi police to ensure that Obama has a safe passage in Delhi? So what people say and what people promise many times, they don't know what is the ground reality. Coming to the police, law and order. For police, basically they do three kinds of functions. Mm-hmm. Number one, traffic management. Number two is security. Number three is general law and order issues which come to the local thanas and issues like that. Mm-hmm. So these three things needs to be compartmentalized. What happens, many times the PSO, who is with me, I find him after 1 week of leaving me, is on the Rajpath and managing the traffic over there. The same person who was with me and who was with me as a security guard, the same person. I get jittery because I thought that he's a professional person, a commando. He's supposed to be to secure a person. But instead, he's managing the traffic the next day, which means that either he doesn't know how to manage traffic or either he didn't know how to secure a person. Then after 2 years, he's put on a thana where he goes and investigates for a murder. Mm-hmm. And investigation for murder is again a separate specialized issue. Unfortunately, in Delhi police, we have not compartmentalized these three different things. Mm-hmm. We have the same set of people doing the same set of things. First of all, we need to compartmentalize these three things. And then law and order at the local level should be given to Delhi government.
Okay, should be given to Delhi government.
Should be Delhi government.
But not
again,
police.
But law and order means managing law and order, managing crime, managing rape, managing any kind of.
So, what you're suggesting is that the Delhi police should be compartmentalized and law and order, the law and order sector should be given, should be handed over to Delhi state.
That is my personal view. But okay. but our party's, whole party's view will come with our manifesto. Mm-hmm. I'm adding this caveat to this.
Okay.
So, security, as far as the security is concerned, because the parliament is here, because the international, at international level, dignitaries come to Delhi. Because Delhi, in Delhi, we've got high commissions and embassies of different countries.
So, the security part
should be with the center government. Traffic should also be with the center government, because traffic and security, they go hand in hand. If you have to provide security to any foreign dignitary, then traffic becomes very important, essential part of that security system. So, we need to compartmentalize, have specialists in these fields and specialize these specialize our police force.
Okay, let's go back to the three major players, including your party, that's Congress, BJP and Aam Aadmi Party. Now, a very interesting and significant thing which is happening is that the Aam Aadmi Party says that the contest is between BJP and Aam Aadmi Party. The BJP says the contest is between BJP and Aam Aadmi Party. But the Congress, which is left behind in this, says the contest is between us and BJP. So, why is it that, you guys are not considering, the Congress is not considering the contest between Congress, BJP and Aam Aadmi Party, and for that fact of matter, none of the three parties are considering that this is a triangular contest, not a one-to-one contest happening out here.
I think that BJP and Aam Aadmi Party, now it is getting more and more clear. Perhaps they are two sides of the same coin. Like I tweeted, Anna ke sab bachche set ho gaye. So, like Shekhar Gupta said, dil ke tukde hazar huye, koi idhar gira, koi udhar gira.
Okay.
So, some people, Shazia Ilmi, Kiran Bedi, who are on one side, and now Kumar Vishwas also may join them. And he's been sulking since long. So, some people with Anna Hazare's movement, who always pledged not to enter politics, who said, made statements always, that is daldal ke andar hum log nahin fasne wale. The same very set of people who used to abuse politicians, politics, now they themselves have plunged deep into politics. The other set is with Kejriwal. So, who knows that tomorrow both of them will join hands together, and this we feel that our fight is with those set of opportunists who are now in the BJP and the Aam Aadmi Party. People whose foundation has been laid on bunch of lies. How can they fight from a building against corruption, wherein the foundation of that building has been built on bunch of lies through false affidavits, through hoodwinking the people? That is what the people need to think.
Okay, you spoke about BJP and Shazia Ilmi and Kiran Bedi joining the party. Now, this has been a very interesting development. In 2013, that's almost a year back when the elections happened, Aam Aadmi Party was led by Arvind Kejriwal. Congress was led by Sheila Dikshit. BJP was led by Harshvardhan, Dr. Harshvardhan. He is now a union minister. A year after the re-elections are happening, Aam Aadmi Party still has Arvind Kejriwal as its face. Congress has changed its leader. Now, you're leading the party into the election as chief of the campaign committee. You've been a very committed party worker and leader in the state. BJP seems to have also changed its track. They've brought in Kiran Bedi. How do you interpret the situation?
Well, first of all, there's a huge difference what BJP has done and what Congress party has done in bringing me as the campaign committee chairman. BJP has imported people not from political spectrum but from outside, thereby indicating that they do not have faith in any of their elected leaders in Delhi.
Mm-hmm.
They do not have faith, or they do not feel that any of their elected MLAs are capable to become the chief minister of Delhi. So my question to them is, why do they hope and how do they hope people to vote for such people to win even MLA elections, when the BJP doesn't have any faith in such people to make them the chief minister face of Delhi? So this is something much, much different than what you say about the Congress party. I have been elected from Delhi three times as MLA, two times as parliament since last 21 years. I have been the president of Delhi University Students Union. I have had an impeccable track record as a minister, both in the center and the state. So, on the other hand, we have Kiran Bedi, who has no experience. If you just look at the speech which she gave, she was scolding her senior party leaders than giving her vision. There was no vision in what she said.
Okay. One very important, another important aspect, which you know seems to be have been left behind or being, you know, is slightly not being focused upon, is the fact that apart from these three political parties, there are other players who are also important in Delhi politics, such as the Bahujan Samajwadi Party, the BSP. They have a significant vote share in Delhi. That does not translate into a number of seats, that many number of seats. Just like Congress, whose vote share came down drastically from 40% to somewhere around 25% comparable to 2008 and 2013, the same happened with the BSP. Their vote share also came down drastically. Some analysts believe that this is where the Aam Aadmi Party benefited. And this time around, Congress says that we have, you know, we've come up with a rejuvenated party with Ajay Maken as a trusted and tested face as our leader. BSP also seems to be, you know, bringing in, putting in a little more force. So, do you believe that these smaller parties like BSP putting in more effort into Delhi elections will help Congress or will hurt the Congress's efforts?
Well, BSP, the history of BSP in Delhi and the Congress party is a bit different. You can't compare the two together. BSP peaked only when Mayawati won in Uttar Pradesh. Mm-hmm. And Mayawati won in Uttar Pradesh with huge margin, and that is after which the elections took place. Mm-hmm. And then with Mayawati was being projected as the prime ministerial face. So their workers were rejuvenated, people from Uttar Pradesh came, she was the chief minister in Uttar Pradesh. And that is why, and that is how they got votes. Before that also, they never got good votes. After that also, they failed to get any votes. So Congress party's getting votes has been persistent. The only exception has been the last election.
2013.
So, yeah, 2013. For BSP, the only exception was before that, 2008. Mm-hmm. So, you can't compare the two parties.
Okay. One more thing out here is that, Ajay Maken as the face of Congress in Delhi seems to have been projected as a very bold step which has been taken by the party. But if you look at the list of 70 candidates which has been released by your party, we're going to contest these elections, not many new faces around, 10 to 12. You've repeated most of your erstwhile sitting MLAs, that is those who won in 2008 or maybe before that, and obviously all those who were sitting MLAs in 2013. One. Two, there was a talk that senior leaders will be brought in to contest assembly elections to, you know, push the prospects of the party. Maybe ex-MPs, all seven who lost in 2014 general elections. But it's just you and Mahabal Mishra who are contesting elections. Why not others?
It's not just me and Mahabal Mishra. For the first time it has happened that any Lok Sabha ex-MP is contesting MLA elections in Delhi. It has never happened in the past. Mm-hmm. So had these people not contested, anyone of had it been so, it wouldn't have made any difference because it has never happened in the past. So, two persons even, Mahabal Mishra and myself contesting the election is something which is new, which is for the first time.
But why only two? Why not all seven
listen,
of them?
Why then? For just an interview before you, some they were asking why are you contesting the elections? Because never it has been in the past that ex-MP. So, if we contest, then we are asked the question. If we are not contesting, then we are asked the question. I don't think this is right. The answer to the other question is, that it is, we are repeating many of our sitting MLAs. They are not the only ones who won in 2008 mm-hmm. or 2013. Mm-hmm. They are the ones who have been continuously winning three elections, four elections, five elections. Mm-hmm. So why we have repeated such strong candidates who have been continuously winning three, four, five elections mm-hmm. is that people have started missing them. In last 1 year, when they were not the elected MLAs, people have made comparative analysis between them and the new MLAs. And this would be to our advantage. If we have any hope, it is in these MLAs who have won repeatedly, and last 1 year, the people of Delhi or the people of their constituency were missing them. And if you ask whether they'll vote for which party, they'll give you a different answer. If you ask whether you will vote for Mr. X, Mr. Y from the Congress party who has been an MLA for three or four consecutive terms, they will say, I will vote for Mr. X of Congress party.
Okay, one last question and a very important one from the Congress's perspective is the issue of infighting within the Congress. Now, let me elaborate a little bit. You became the chief of the campaign committee of the party. There are, several people who believe that there are factions within the party, there are leaders within the party who thought that it is their chance to say, to name a few. Let's start with the PCC president, Arvinder Singh Lovely. He was given charge of the party after Congress lost elections. He was the PCC president. Some say that he should have been the face of the party. And it seems also that Mr. Lovely seems to be sulking. He's not present in the press conferences which is being addressed by you. Is there a disconnect?
No, not at all. Please, don't. Lovely and I, we have always been a team. And people who know Delhi politics, they know it well that both of us have been right since beginning. Both of us have been a team. And please don't, I don't find any basis in this. Secondly, about other small groupism, not this, other groupism. Has there been any time in Congress where there has been no groupism? No factionalism.
So are you accepting this fact that from Sheila Dixit era to Ajay Maken era, the transition is not smooth?
Listen, every time, it is not era to era. Within one era also, there has been groupism and factionalism. This is something which has always, I must admit frankly, in every time, every election, there is groupism and factionalism. I must admit and agree. But simultaneously, you should also agree that in BJP also, there is enormous groupism. Are all BJP leaders happy with Kiran Bedi being inducted? No. In Aam Aadmi Party also, there is groupism. Are all volunteers of Aam Aadmi Party happy with the ticket distribution? No. So, groupism is something which is universal, which is there in all political parties. This groupism is something which has been there from the time the politics was born. Ever since we started fighting contesting elections.
And you believe that this will not dent your prospects?
Because this is something which always happens. This is something which we all are used to. So, this is something which will come and go. But the people vote for the candidates. People vote for the party. People vote for their own choice of chief ministerial candidates.
Thank you so much. Thank you for being with us. This is about TV and best of luck for the forthcoming elections. So, this was Senior Congress Leader Ajay Maken in a freewheeling conversation with us on Delhi Assembly elections. We'll come back again with a different personality at a different time. Till then, keep watching Rajya Sabha Television.